Now at 5:30, the group redesigning a local park is hoping to install LED lighting. The move could cut energy costs.
But the group says it needs to raise thousands of dollars for the project.
Green Team reporter TJ Del Santo joins us now in Newport from the East Bay Mobile Newsroom with a story that's new at 5:30.
Queen Anne Park in Newport is getting a major makeover. Centuries worth of history will meet up with modern day lifestyles.
The space where Queen Anne Square is on the corner of Church and Thames in Newport has served a number of purposes, most recently as a park.
It was a nice open space, but it didn't have a lot of amenities. There was no place to sit inside the park. It needed some better trees. It had something contemporary in terms of its art and its architecture.
Designed by Maya Lin, the park will have three shallow foundations, one typical of each of the 17th, 18th, and 19th centuries. This will show the history of the property and serve as a community gathering spot. The sidewalk in front has been widened. There will be lots of places to sit inside the park, and there will even be free Wi-Fi offered. The $3.5 million project is being funded privately, but an added cost has arisen, the cost of the lighting.
The average street light has about 150 watts of power in it, and the same LED light would be produced by about 30 watts.
15 posts will light the paths in the park and will be similar to the historic light posts in the neighborhood. The savings in the long run could be as high as 78%, but the upfront cost for the fixtures is large. The Newport Restoration Foundation hopes to raise $55,000 by the end of the month.
People won't donate a little bit to us through the Kickstarter campaign, and it's a great way to be able to donate any amount of money from $5 right on up.
And the park is expected to be open on May 31st. For the Green Team, I'm TJ Del Santo, Eyewitness News.